So it's Wednesday, the sun is shining, it's going to be a beautiful day. It's already scorching hot and it's only 9:20 in the morning. Kind of a bit miffed that I've put a hoodie on, but I'm going to put it in my backpack when I get on the bus, so it's going to be a great day. I'm meeting up with my poster group at 11 o'clock and then I've got a couple of lectures all about our leaflet and our rationale, so yeah, we'll see what today brings. Hopefully it's going to be a great day, the sun's shining, got my tea, what more can I ask for? Stairs in the new building today.
You can put that on vlog as well.
Oh yeah. Jojo. Morning. Are you getting up today? No? I don't want to get up today. Okay. It's Friday. Whoop whoop. I'm still buzzing from last night's expedition. It was amazing. And oh, it's just fantastic. I've got my tea, the sun's shining, today's going to be a beautiful day. I've got some filming at the uni. I think I'm just going to be showing the new students around in the video, so that should be fun. So I'll see you all later. So we're at university, we're filming some important information for all the students, current and new, because our building's amazing.
There's around 100 different procedures available for us.
It's Saturday, I've got my tea. I'm on the way to the QE for some manual handling training. It's very early, it's 6:30. I'm waiting for my train. The training's 8:30 till 11:30, so enjoy. I've arrived, I'm 45 minutes early as always, and I'm just gonna sit here and wait. This is up in the skills suite section. I'm gonna wait until I can go in, finish my tea, and hopefully it'll be all right. So I'm back from my manual handling session. So this session was at the QE. This is for my bank shifts as a healthcare assistant whilst I'm doing my nursing degree. So if you're looking for part-time work, if you're already doing part-time work, as you'll know, we have to refresh every single year manual handling. So I have to do manual handling twice a year, once as a student nurse and once for my bank shifts. But it's great because I've genuinely learned something from this session compared to my last session, so that's really good. And I can take that out into practice with me, so it's great. It's all learning, so I don't mind. And I got paid for this one, so... So now I'm going to talk you through just the past couple of days at uni, because I haven't had a chance to do that yet because I've been so involved with my Real Bodies expedition and things like that. If you haven't watched that video yet, go back and have a look at it because it's just amazing. You're going to be wild. So university. On Thursday we had, in the morning, we had a really good session on FGM or female genital mutilation. And it was just so emotional, and I know a little bit anyway because on my bank shifts I work in the sexual health clinics and we do get just a little bit of training there and what to look out for. It was a lot more in depth, this one, and it was just, some of the stories she told us was just heartbreaking, and it was a really emotional start to the day, and I think everyone was just like drained because it was just emotional. And then the other session of the day we had all about care planning again. So as part of one of our assignments we have to write a care plan, and then we have to write a rationale to why we've written that care plan and the evidence-based practice behind it. So the lectures Thursday and Friday were surrounding falls, constipation and wound management. So the sessions are really good, really, really useful sessions. They're fantastic. Just, they've made it just so easy to do, which is a bonus considering we've got quite a lot of workload coming up. So the way the sessions have been set out, we had our care plan template and we just went through it on what we should be doing and how we should be writing a care plan. And it's just the rationale we've got right now. That's 1,500 words, and I think I'll be all right with that one. I've got no problems, I don't think, with regards to that rationale. I think that's going to be quite an easy one to write in comparison to the leaflet for some reason, even though they're kind of the same thing, but just different topics. So what have I got coming up? Let's go through that. So I have got my leaflet, which I've done. My rationale for my leaflet, which I've done the first draft, I need to go back and tweak and just add a few bits and take away a few bits. I haven't done my care plan and rationale yet, but I will probably by next week. It shouldn't take that long, I don't think. Well, the care plan at least. The rationale might take a little bit longer. So the care plan will definitely be done by next week. And then we've got our poster presentation, which, to be fair, we've done most of it now. We just need to meet up again, probably run through it a few times, ready for the 11th of July. I keep telling you this. And then we have a maths exam and nursing practice 3 exam, which is anatomy and physiology. We haven't had those lectures yet for those two. That's going to be coming next, I think, in the upcoming weeks. To be honest, all I've got left to do is my care plan and rationale, practice the poster, and then that's that block done, because I've pretty much done them bits. Oh, and just retweak my rationale from my leaflet as well. And then those bits are done, and all I've got to do then is revise. And that's it. So, to be fair, I feel proper organised. I think I've really organised myself this half of the year, and just I've got it and started it as it's come in, instead of waiting till the last minute, because you can't physically wait till the last minute for this sort of work. And if anyone's doing that right now, I'm panicking for you. Please get on it, start it, do your work, be organised, because otherwise you don't want to leave it to the last minute and then fail. That's the last thing. So I like to get things done and organised as they come in, so then I've got all that time to edit, retweak them, and just change a few things. If I find something interesting, I can add that back in, and just little things, you know. Top tips: if you are a first year student or a future nursing student, you will hear all this negativity around second year and the workload, and second year is the worst year out of the 3 years. I've heard it a lot. So I'm just going to tell you now, don't listen to those negative thoughts, because second year for me has been amazing so far. I've loved every minute of second year. And as long as you get organised and keep on top of your work as it's launched, you're going to be amazing. You're going to be fine. You're not going to have any stress, any worries, and that's it, really. So I love second year. Whoop, whoop. Come on for the second year. So tomorrow I am off. I've got a beautiful day off. I'm going to have a nice lie-in. I don't tend to lie in past 7 a.m. I usually tend to wake up and I panic because I think I should be doing something. And tomorrow, I'm not planning on doing anything. I might just start the care plan and retweak. I keep saying this word, retweak. Where's this word come from? I'm just going to just go through my rationale for my leaflet and just edit it a little bit. And then at least those things are done and out the way. And that's it. I mean, I might just do nothing tomorrow. I have done a lot of work, and I've got time in the evenings and I've got time in the mornings to sort of do those little bits. So I'm not really that worried about doing any work tomorrow, but we'll see. I have a habit of not being able to sit still, so if I plan to have a day off and do nothing, it doesn't tend to happen. I usually do some form of work, because I'm strange. So I forgot, shall we have a look in the garden? Because I haven't checked on my strawberries for a little while, so let's see what's growing. Onions are growing. My bush is looking amazing. Strawberries, I've got some little ones here growing. I've got this big one, look at this. That is massive. Something's took a chunk out of that. I am not happy. My tomatoes are growing on this one though. Look at that. Tomatoes are growing. My peas. Oh, look how tall they are. Almost at the top of the thing. Oh, look, they're all holding hands. This one's gone over to this one. And they're joining together. Like a little pea family. How cute. My cucumber is grown. And that started to get flowers on it now. I'm not too sure where the cucumbers grow from. Oh, there, that's the cucumber. Is that it? Wow. Yes, I've got cucumbers. I've got 1, 2, 3. And then I'm assuming these are going to be cucumbers. But I have loads. What? I'm so excited for this. What else?
And I've got this funky strawberry here. Looks like a little paw. Amazing. So they're all doing really well. Lavender's growing. Oh, the pink's coming out now. They were white. Can you see that? They're growing beautifully. My sunflower. Yeah, there he is. Something's been eaten down here, but the top seems to be growing quite well now. My mint is overgrowing. My thyme is still thyme. Looks like something's been sat on top of it. Oh, what's this? I don't really know what that is growing. I'm assuming a squirrel has plucked something from somewhere and tried to bury it, maybe. I'm not too sure what that is. And my potatoes, look at these. Hopefully there's going to be a lot of potatoes in this sack ready for us. So that's your lot, guys. So that's it from me for now. I shall see you all next week, and I hope you all have a great Sunday. I hope you have a great week. Just embrace the day, take on the day, empower yourself. Just be amazing, stay unique, and see you next week.